isn't liberty worth fighting for?
You're tuned to Radio Free Tatooine. With your host, Sean.
Right now I feel like I can take on the whole empire myself.
Amy.
Technically, I outrank you, right?
And John.
Oh, I don't even know what I'm doing here. We're wasting our time.
Where the outer rim isn't soundproof.
What's happening, Tatooiners? I'm Sean.
I'm John.
Amy.
And we are Radio Free Tatooine, bringing you 100 days of Star Wars. Today is day number 88, and we got a serious question here. Why isn't Ezra Bridger around in A New Hope? The main protagonist of Rebels, which is supposed to be kind of a lead-in to A New Hope.
Yeah.
He's not anywhere to be seen.
Well, I think the obvious answer is that it was written 30-some-odd years after A New Hope, and so, whatever.
Oh,
that's the obvious answer.
Yeah,
that's... I think, story-wise, well, Amy's about heads out to explode. What do you got, Amy?
No, I'm just...
You don't know the answer?
I mean... Unfortunately, I feel like he must be dead.
Yep.
This is before he earned the alias of Wedge Antilles.
No way.
Now follow me with this one, because...
No, because he's an Aftermath, and he's definitely not a Jedi in Aftermath.
No, he...
You burn.
Yeah, I don't... That's the best I've got.
Here's my theory. Either one, I think Amy's right. Either he dies, although that's a little dark for Rebels.
Mm-hmm.
So he may die in another medium after they introduce him in Rebels. Or, and this is my actual preferred theory,
mm-hmm.
he turns to the dark side.
Mm.
And that's why he's not around us. He's no longer a Rebel or a Jedi. They have touched on his
Kylo
dark...
Ren is Ezra Bridger.
That would be... He'd be old. He'd be too old.
Yeah, but, you know, the Force is strong with that one.
No, I think that in the end, it's going to end up being... I mean, and I guess it's overdone a little bit with the Padawan turning evil against the Master. But they kind of reference his kind of raw ability with the Force. There's a lot of how they talked about Anakin. I know we mentioned this briefly during season one when we talked about it.
Yeah,
I think
he does seem to be pretty natural at it.
My actual prediction is not that he's Wedge. That's nonsense. But is that he probably isn't featured in the movie, but he's like there, so to speak.
Yeah,
you know, like he's just.
I think that's the official
explanation. Off on some other mission or whatever, you know what I mean?
Right, it's a whole galactic rebellion. The mm-hmm. fact that we don't see one specific character
out of our dozen that we actually know from the rebellion,
right.
You know,
who's not particularly public about being a Jedi, you know, is not shocking. I'm hoping story-wise that he does either A, die, because I'm sure it'll be heart-wrenching, which is what I look for in a story. Or
maybe
you remember me rooting for Kanan to die during season one of Rebels.
Yeah,
I still think it would have been better, but it's not the point. Or he turns to the dark side.
I'm the only one that's going to be sunshine and rainbows. He lives. He's fine.
He's just not there. Don't bother talking. He's okay.
He's just watching to make sure. I mean, he'd jump in if they really need him, but they seem to have it under control,
yeah,
so he's just going to, like...
He really lets himself go, and he becomes Porkins. I think that's what...
Oh, my.
His hair is long and blue, because that's a thing.
Oh, gosh.
All right, well, we will be back tomorrow for another installment of 100 Days of Star Wars.